amazing and helped done everything in it. I couldn't have done any of it without her, and she's really been behind a lot of the things that have made this really special. So I just want to say thank you very much, Mum. And Flowers, would you thank you? And it's a wee gift to say thank you as well. Next, I want to say thank you to all my bridesmaids who've helped me out and given me a lovely hen party and have been there for me. And it's lovely to have you all here today, looking so lovely. And especially thanks to Laura Henderson, for those of you who don't know, who's my chief bridesmaid and has been just incredible and gave me a really amazing hen party and has just been lovely and supportive and done everything to make it special. Thank you very much. A few other thank yous to Fiona and Mary and Aidan for the music in the church and also here. It's been fabulous. Thank you very much. Thank you to the ushers, to Mark and Gordon and Lawrence for helping us out of the church. That was lovely. And I want to say a final thank you to Kashmar for coming all this way to be with me. Thank you. I love you and you make me very happy. Aww. And that's it for me, so I'm going to hand over to the father of the bride.
That's your little brother. It's your little brother or older brother? Bigger brother.
Thank you, Stephanie. And good evening, everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, hope everybody's having a good time. And Stephanie and Kashmar, obviously, looking fantastic, aren't they?
Yes.
So, I've been looking forward to making this speech for quite some time. 26 years, in fact. Just over 26 years. And not just to mark the occasion, which hopefully is one of the happiest that Stephanie and Kashmar will have in their lives. But also it gives me an opportunity to right a bit of a wrong for my own wedding 31 years ago. Some of you here were at that wedding might remember my speech. Probably you won't remember my speech if you were at that wedding. It was remarkable only for its brevity. But then I hated the idea of public speaking. Not like now, of course. And I love it. And I'm so anxious that I couldn't even think about it, let alone writing the things down. So I just thought, well, inspiration will strike. And of course, inspiration didn't strike. Well, that's not quite true. Inspiration struck, but it struck Julie, who was sitting next to me. So she made a speech which was forthright and articulate. I didn't. The other problem, I guess, was that back in the early 1980s, video technology was the thing, so everybody had their weddings videoed. So we had our wedding video, we had a professional video photographer videoing our wedding. So we got to watch the whole thing back. It lasted for 27 seconds. Nowadays you can go on the internet and you search these things so you know what you're supposed to say. In those days, you just were supposed to know. But I was supposed to say how beautiful Julie looked, but I didn't. I was supposed to do lots of other things. But I didn't. The whole thing lasted for 27 seconds, from beginning to end. So, luckily, Julie's a woman. And like most women, she tends to forgive and forget her husband's failings. She's barely mentioned it since. But it did bother me. So when Stephanie was born 26 years ago, just over 26 years ago, my first reaction was fantastic. I get to make another speech. At her wedding. And luckily, I would have 20 odd years in which to compose it. Unfortunately, we all didn't spend 20 years composing it. It's just been a task of the last week. But You'll be pleased to hear, I've got 35 minutes worth of it. Settle down.
Anyway,
today's not about me, it's about Stephanie and Kathra. So, isn't she beautiful?
Yes.
And isn't Kathra handsome? Just on a side note, and apropos of nothing, if you're 6'4" with broad shoulders and narrow hips, and you need a wedding suit, don't go shopping in Dundee. If you're 4'6" with narrow hips, narrow shoulders, broad hips maybe, but not really well. There was only one day that I think Stephanie was more beautiful in my eyes, and that was that day 26 years ago, just over there. She wasn't wearing a dress then, but she was beautiful. Anyway, everyone who knows Stephanie knows that as well as being a beauty, she's got a personality. She's got great strength of character and a very strong personality. This has always been the case, even when she was with. We came to live in Cooper 23 years ago, and I was a bit of a crossroads at my career, and Julie's job took us to Fife, which is why we came. So I was going to be a stay-at-home dad, a housewife, do a bit of ironing in the morning, play a bit of golf, pick the kids up, that kind of thing. That was the plan anyway. It's quite unusual in those days. I think it's more common now. But unfortunately, I kind of reckoned without Stephanie. So my strength of character basically was no match for hers. There were a number of points on which we disagreed. Onions, for example, which we still disagree about, mashed potatoes, and most of the things really that are cooked. And sadly, we found it difficult to resolve our differences in a civilised manner. Julie would come home from work, and I would be sitting in one corner of the room staring at her. She would be sitting in the other corner of the room staring at me. And it just didn't really work out. Anyway, 3 months later, I was a broken man. And I went off, ironically, to work in psychiatry, where my first job was with the criminally insane, who were surprisingly easy to manage. Interestingly, I have picked up some useful transferable skills from being a housewife. Fortunately, to us, our friend Christine, who's here somewhere, Christine Wilson, she stepped into the breach. She came to work for us as a nanny, and luckily she proved more than a match for Stephanie. So, two tips, two in the page. So anyway, Stephanie, she's full of spirit, which is a good thing. And as she grew up, she threw herself into life with enthusiasm and spirit. Dancing was a great passion when she was younger, and when she got old enough, travelling. So I think the first time you went away by yourself was Paris, wasn't it? With school friends, she'd won the Money Underground National gambling. Four and up to take her to Paris for a few days, and then after that she spread her wings. She went to South America, Ecuador, Africa, and of course the Caribbean, which is where she met Kathra. She and Alex, Brendan's fiancé, were saving turtles in Jamaica. I'm not sure what they were saving them from, or what they did with them when they saved them. They got a canteen of cutlery if they saved them up, I don't know, anyway. Stephanie, when she was there, told us that she met a young man, and which was great, but of course, as all fathers know, you want to keep your daughter close, but you want to keep your daughter's boyfriend even closer. I think the Caribbean's quite a long way away, frankly, so you'd like to be able to, excuse me, hand gesture. But not able to do that. Anyway, as time went by and it became clear this was a serious relationship, it looked like he might be the one. There's no doubt denying it, I did start to have a bit of a concern. Quite apart from not having the opportunity to do the eyes thing, there was the other issue, which everybody knows about, but nobody says. People from the Caribbean have something of a reputation, and people from Jamaica in particular have something of a reputation. So, anyway, that was in the background. I never mentioned it to Stephanie, obviously, but it was there. Trust I did trust Stephanie. She's been well brought up. She's got the values of the house, and she's got good common sense. But anyway, never said it. Sometimes love can be blind, though. I think we all know that. Anyway, we were delighted when they got engaged, and very relieved when they got through all the legal hurdles, and they were quite difficult legal hurdles for getting Cashmore a visa, and even more so when we got to meet him for the first time in Newcastle last August, which incidentally was the coldest they'd ever been in his life up to that point. Interestingly, that was our summer. But knocking down, you know, they have got a reputation, so I just had to get it out of the way. I didn't do it on the first day because the poor guy had been travelling all the way, been flying. A train up from London, so we'll have it to the second day. But Cashmore, be honest, do you like cricket? I said, well, that's alright, really, but I prefer football, thank God. We got it out in the open and it wasn't a problem. So we'll talk about these things. So. So Joe and I took him along to Celtic Park, the first opportunity that we got, and so he's been to see the famous Glasgow Celtic. Even better, he's got, he takes golf like a duck to water. He's got the best natural golf swing I've ever seen in a young man, so that's fantastic. So well done, Cash. So we've got to know him pretty well over the last 6 months, and there is no doubt he is a very fine young man. A credit to his family. Great credit to his family, although apparently your dad's a cricket fan, isn't he? So. And it's been tough enough to come over to the UK and be separated from all your family and loved ones these last few months. So and we're really sorry that the circumstances are such that your family can't be with us today. But we're all thinking about them, and I know that they'd be very proud of you, as we are. So. Also not here, but very much in our thoughts, Stephanie's grandparents, Joan and Norman, Julie's parents, Jerry and Anne, mine, who would have absolutely loved to have been here today, and they would have been very proud also. So, we'll think about them. But, we'll finish with a toast. That's the traditional thing to do, because that was on the internet. So, we'll toast to Stephanie and Cashmore. Let's hope that you're as happy in your marriage as Julie and I have been in ours, and that you have a wonderful future left there. Stephanie and Cashmore.
And now to the luckiest man in the room, the groom.
Good evening, guys. I must say, Stephanie is the prettiest, most beautiful girl I've ever met. And I love her a lot. And this is our special day, and it will last forever. I love you. A few days after Steph came to Jamaica, we met. I found it within myself to make a ring and give it to her, not knowing that this would that day would finalized to this day. And I must say, Stephanie, I love you with everything I've got, and we will always be together. I must say, honey, you are the most beautiful woman I've ever laid eyes on. I promise to spend the rest of my life with you. I'm delighted to be your husband. I love you so much. Brandon. Brandon. Brandon, my best one. Thank you for being here by my side when I need someone. Thank you very much. Thank you. and finally your son-in-law. And I must say, you are absolutely great, and you are more than a father that I should be. And I thank you very much for all that you have done for us. Thank you. Julie has been there for me, like, every day. Julie is lovely, and I must say that you have done my really even though I know sometimes it gets rough. I've seen it. You've done well. Thank you for all that you've done for us, too. Thanks. And I must say thank you to Maureen for having me last night. She took me away from my wife. So, thank you, Maureen, for having me wherever you are, Rishi. Oh, thank you, Maureen, for all that, your warm accommodation. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you.
I hope it's not the last time, Kev.
It won't be the last time, I promise.
With your wife next time.
And John Cummings, our photographer, there he is. He has been there for us, taking photographs of our engagement photograph on the beach, and it was lovely, and I thank you very much, John. On behalf of Stefan, thank you very much for your patience and your time. Thank you. And to all, and to everybody that's here, thank you for your presence and being here with us. And thank you for your kind gestures. Thank you very much. Have a lovely and a blessed evening. Thank you.